We decided to come here because we find in this island magnificent, tremendous reaction of men to adapt to very hard conditions to pursue with this life. So here in this island, in fact, the conditions were really terrible because there was almost no water and almost no soil, and the men had to do pretty much everything to establish his life here, conditions to live here. And the vernacular architecture is a magnificent example of adaptation of man to these rough conditions. Here, in a volcanic island, still active, we find only basalt stone, that you see, this dark stone, and wood, some wood, and pretty much everything is done with these two materials. So it's a very good and unique example of vernacular architecture. That's the reason why, the main reason why we choose to make our summer school here in Lajes do Pico in Açores.
The place itself feels like, it feels like a little home away from home. And architecture-wise, I would say, because this is very new to me, I am not used to this at all, so I am just trying to absorb as much as possible and trying to relate to things that I've learned back home. Everyone has been like really helpful. All the professors, they've been like answering all my doubts, and we just like we are just like learning from each other's cultures, and yeah, it's been going great.
To be here in Açores, it's a wonderful experience to learn about this beautiful architecture and to learn with professors and colleagues from all around the world and different universities. It's very great.
One thing that we get to learn is how to do this from the historical way, learning through tradition that's been used just throughout time, through generations and generations, and there's a lot of wisdom to that, and that's in danger of being lost. So I love to come here and learn with the school and with all these different craftsmen and connect with them, because you know, these are treasures that need to be preserved and passed on through the generations.
Traditional architecture is based on the collective, selective, additive and cumulative wisdom of many generations of mankind, expressing its genius and inventivity. It's an intelligence and know-how collected over many generations, handed over, adapted, adjusted, and refreshed. Tradition is derived from historical experience and expertise, but it is not synonymous with historical, ancient, or antique. Tradition is always new and modern because it takes the best and most relevant from the past.
For me to be and to choose this architecture, traditional and vernacular architecture summer school, is some way to learn and focus on some subjects that I have learned in university, and I currently in my daily work don't get in practice.
Ilha do Pico, it's amazing to study and learn about traditional architecture, and this small island in the middle of the ocean, it's an inspiring place to learn about traditional way and to build and to live, to habitat our planet in the sustainability way. The group this year of the summer school, it's really nice and passionate, and we are enjoying this time together here.
This summer school is possible thanks to a number of institutions. There are several important foundations supporting our activity, among them Richard Driehaus and Fundação Serra Henriques, and also the Cava Foundation of Kalam, the restoration company. And this is also possible thanks to the collaboration of many universities where the faculty come from, universities such as the University of Notre Dame in Indiana, the University of Miami, the University of the Politécnica of Madrid, the Portucalense, the University of the Basque Country, and a number of other universities that are contributing in different ways, sending lecturers, sending faculty to this event. And also the same for the participants. The participants come from all over the world, and they are all sharing an interest, a passion for learning from these traditions. And when we chose this place, Pico Island, and in particular the municipality of Lajes do Pico, which municipality has been instrumental for making this possible, we chose a place which was particularly telling in this sense, because it's a place where the scarcity of resources, the fact of being a rather isolated island with very little soil in the past, made the local tradition very inventive, and also the ingenuity of it is astonishing. And there is so much to learn on how to build meaningful and beautiful places with so little materials and options available, that this makes it a perfect location for a program like this.